This section should give a short introduction to head injuries, neck injuries, back injuries, chest and abdominal injuries. The brain is free to move a little within the skull and can thus be shaken by a violent blow. Head injuries can be caused by a blow to the head, crush, other blow of violence which shakes the brain, or internal bleeding. If we have to deal with a head injury, there can be different types of injuries which have different types of symptoms. Concussion, cerebral hemorrhage, or skull fracture. Remember that a patient that is unconscious can be unconscious because of circulation failure and not necessarily because of the head injury. Treatment of a head injury includes the following actions. ABC. Patient examination. Oxygen. Recovery position, if unconscious. Close control of blood pressure. Keep the head raised. Close surveillance of the patient. Note extent and time of change in patient condition. Major blows to the head, neck and back may cause a fracture or sprain. On board, this may occur by a fall, being struck by a falling object, or a heavy blow to the neck or back. The symptoms of neck and back injuries are great pain in neck or back, reduced mobility, electric shock through the backbone, sensory deficit, unconsciousness, spinal shock, drop in blood pressure, lack of bladder and bowel control. Head injury, usually increased blood pressure. The treatment of neck and back injuries includes the following actions. ABC. Patient examination. Oxygen. Immobilize the patient. Recovery position. Vital organs such as heart, lungs, and the main arteries are protected by the rib cage, thorax. Therefore, if the chest is exposed to major blows, life-threatening complications may arise in connection with fractures to the rib cage. Rupture of the main artery causes massive bleeding. Rupture to main bronchi causes major inner air leakage that leads to pressure increase and major emphysema. Rupture to the lungs, veins and arteries causes massive bleeding. Damage to the heart muscle causes decreased pumping effect, circulation failure. The above-mentioned damages are all, to a certain extent, life-threatening and difficult to treat by general first aid. Pneumothorax, or a collapsed lung, due to air or gas accumulating in the pleural space, may in some cases develop into life-threatening situations. In particular, tension pneumothorax is a life-threatening emergency, where increasing amounts of air accumulate around the lung with each breath, such that the heart and other lung become compressed. This is treated by inserting a needle below the second rib in line with the nipple on the side of the problem. An open pneumothorax can result from a large wound to the chest wall, allowing air to move freely in and out of the chest cavity, preventing the lung from expanding. This can be initially treated by placing a dressing on the wound and taping down only three sides. This allows the air to move out on expiration and prevents it from moving back in on inspiration. The lungs are kept from collapsing by the liquid in the pleural cavity, that is between the chest cavity and the lung. When you inhale, the pleural cavity is pulled away from the lung. The lung is attached to it due to a vacuum-type pull. Should this vacuum disappear, the lung will collapse. When we exhale, the intercostal muscles and the diaphragm relax. When we inhale, the diaphragm contracts, as well as the intercostal muscles, and because of the vacuum, the lungs expand and are filled with air.